joins us now live.
Shelley, we've learned tonight that it's not just going to be residential neighborhoods like this one that are affected. We're standing in front of a business that's in a residential neighborhood. Businesses like these are now going to be on the hook as well. We spoke to one city councilor who says this ban might be going too far.
I feel very concerned about those people and families that put the barbed wire for reason.
Councilor Ken Sanchez wasn't there for the city council vote Monday when they banned barbed wire on top of people's fences, but he wishes he was.
I probably would have voted against it.
Sanchez took us to a Northwest Albuquerque business across the street from his mother's house.
They didn't want to put the barbed wire, but because of the problems they were having and the thefts and break-ins, they had no other choice to protect their investment.
Because that business is in a residential zone, it and every other home or business in a residential area has 6 months to take down the wire. Sanchez explains why.
And it really looks awful. I mean, it looks like we're in front of a prison. And if somebody wants to locate in this area, they may say, well, really, how safe is this neighborhood?
But the looks haven't led to complaints, at least in Sanchez's office.
In 15 years, I've never gotten a call or a complaint because somebody has barbed wire in their neighborhood.
So maybe you put up a fence like this, thinking you're still going to be in compliance and feel safe. But really, just how much protection are you getting from some of these spikes? Probably not very much.
Sanchez says the council needs to think twice about telling people how to protect their property.
Is this an example of the city overstepping a little bit in terms of telling people how to protect their homes?
It could be.
Now for this one that really need the barbed wire, or for homeowners who are feeling unsafe, Sanchez says he'd like to see some exceptions to the rule being made. Now, we also spoke to another city councilor, Debbie O'Malley, over the phone today. She voted in favor of the ban. She tells us that the city has plenty of regulations on what you can and can't do on your property, and this is just another one. Reporting live in Northwest Albuquerque, I'm Tanya Mendez, KOAT, Action 7 News.
The barbed wire ban has a lot of you fired up on our Facebook page. Michael O'Connor writes, removing barbed wire will force homeowners to resort to guns to protect their property. This could cause an increase in shooting incidents and possible loss of life over mistaken intrusion. And Eva Ballesteros says, next they're going to ban locks on our doors. Crazy ridiculous. People should be allowed to protect their property. If you'd like to give your opinion, just go to the KOAT Facebook.